Welcome back to this next video, and in this video we are going to talk about the inactivated or killed vaccines. Before going into the inactivated or killed vaccines, let us talk about the classification of the vaccines. The vaccines, they are broadly divided into two classes. One of the class, they are known as the whole agent vaccines, and the other class that is known as the subunit vaccines. In this particular class, the whole agent vaccines, the live attenuated vaccines, and the inactivated or killed vaccines, they are included. And in the subunit vaccine, as the name indicates, we are talking about the subunit. So in this particular subunit vaccine, part or the product of the pathogenic organism that is utilized as a vaccine. We discussed about the live attenuated vaccines in the previous video, and I'll share the link in the description. And in this particular video, we are going to talk about the inactivated or killed vaccines. Now, the first question is that if we are available with the live attenuated vaccines, why are we going for the inactivated or killed vaccines? The reason is that there are certain problems in the live attenuated vaccines which compels the scientist to go for other options. And one of the other options that is the inactivated or killed vaccines. The problems in the live attenuated vaccine that we discussed in the last video were that there are chances that the live attenuated vaccines, is they are live one, but we have attenuated them, they can mutate back to their disease causing state, and in that particular state it can cause disease in the recipient. The other problem was that the live attenuated vaccines, they required refrigeration, which is actually a problem in the developing countries. So the live attenuated vaccine was not an option for those particular developing countries where there was problem of the refrigeration. And the third and the most important problem in the live attenuated vaccine was there was some adverse reaction when the individual, they were given the live attenuated vaccines. Keeping in view these problems, the inactivated or killed vaccine, they are made in certain cases where the live attenuated vaccines create these kind of the problems. Now, how the inactivated or killed vaccines, they are formed? How are you going to make them? The inactivated vaccines, they are usually produced by growing the bacterium or viruses. Depending on the vaccine that you are making, if you are making a bacterial vaccines, so you are going to grow the bacteria, or if you are interested in the viral vaccines, so you are going to grow the virus in the culture media. So first you grow them, and after growing them, you usually inactivate them with the heat or chemicals. And in case of chemicals, the most common chemical that is used for the killing or the inactivation, that is the formalin. Now, the heat or the chemical that you use, they actually destroy the pathogen, and they cannot replicate, but the epitopes or the proteins that are present on the surface of the pathogens, they maintain some of the integrity, and that some integrity is actually responsible for evoking the immune system and thereby make an adaptive immune response. Now, these killed vaccine, when they are manufactured correctly, the vaccine is not infectious if you are making them correctly. Keep in mind this thing, we will discuss that this is a limitation of the killed vaccines if they are not manufactured correctly. But when these killed vaccine, they are manufactured correctly, the vaccine is not infectious because you have killed it, but is the properly produced vaccine do not reproduce. Usually booster shots, they are required periodically to reinforce the immune response. Now, if you remember the live vaccines, they were reproducing, they were increasing their number, so there was a continuous immune response produced by the individual. But in this particular case, as you have killed them, so they are not going to replicate, and if they are not going to replicate, that means you need booster shots periodically to reinforce the immune response and generate a stronger immune response. Properties of the live attenuated the killed vaccines, sorry, the properties of the killed vaccines are that these vaccines, they are not alive and they cannot replicate. So this is one of the important property of the killed vaccine, that if they are not alive and they cannot replicate, that means they cannot revert back to its original form to cause the disease. That was one of the major problem in the live vaccines. The second important property of the killed vaccine is that these vaccines cannot cause the disease from infection. We have a detailed discussion on the adverse reaction in the first video, and I'm sharing the link in the description. So the killed vaccine is, they cannot cause disease from infection. So they are, even you can give this to the immunodeficient person. The live vaccine, they are not suitable for the immunodeficient person because they are live and they can reproduce, but is these killed vaccines, they can be given to the immunodeficient patient because they cannot cause a disease in them. As they do not have the adverse reaction, so these vaccines, the killed vaccine, they are more stable and safer than the live vaccines. And another important property is that is you're dealing with the killed vaccines. So the killed vaccine, they do not require refrigeration and they can be easily stored and transported in a freeze-dried form, which make them accessible to the people in developing countries. So this is one of the major advantage, that these kind of the vaccines, they are easily available in the developing countries as compared to the live vaccines. If you look at the examples of the killed vaccine that are available, so if you talk about the viral killed vaccines, the most important one are the vaccines for the polio, the hepatitis A, the rabies and the influenza. And the examples of the bacterial killed vaccines, they are the pertussis, the typhoid, the cholera and the plague vaccines. They are in the category of the bacterial killed vaccines. If you talk about the limitations of the killed vaccines, one of the important limitation of the killed vaccine is that if you are, as you are dealing with the killed pathogens, they actually stimulate a very weaker immune response than do the live vaccines. As you are killing them by heat, you are killing them by the chemicals, so most of their epitopes, they get destroyed. So as compared to the live vaccines, they generate a very weaker kind of the immune response. And this kind of the weaker immune response is actually covered by the adjuvants that we will discuss in the next slide. So it would likely take several additional doses or booster shots to maintain a person's immunity. In the live vaccine, single or maximum of two doses, they are enough to maintain a person's immunity. But in case of the killed viruses, you have to give them additional doses or booster shots because of their weaker immune response to maintain a person's immunity. Now, this is one of the major drawback in areas where people do not have regular access to the health care and can't get booster shots on time. So if they cannot get the booster shots on time, that means the earlier shots, they are of no value to these individuals, because the initial shots, they were not enough to maintain a person's immunity. So this is one of the limitations of the killed vaccine. Another important limitation of the killed vaccine is that if they are not manufactured correctly, by that I mean if they are not properly inactivated, so the vaccine can be infectious because you are actually giving the intact infectious particle to the individual. So you have to keep in mind that these killed vaccine should be manufactured correctly. That means they should be properly killed so that they do not have intact and the infectious particles in the shots. If you compare the live and the killed vaccine, this table is actually a very quick overview of the differences between the live and the killed vaccines. If you talk about the agent in the live vaccines, that is a live attenuated organism or organism of lower virulence. But if you talk about the organism in the killed one, you are killing the organism. The immune response in case of the live vaccine is stronger as compared to the live vaccine. The immune response is relatively poor in the kill vaccines. Booster immunization or the booster shots, they are not required in the live vaccines, but they are required in the kill vaccine. If you talk about the adjuvants, they are not required in the live vaccines, but they are required in the kill vaccines. So what are these adjuvants? The adjuvant, it is actually an ingredient that is used in some vaccines that help create a stronger immune response in people receiving the vaccines. In simple words, you can say that the adjuvants, they help vaccines work better. And the most commonly used adjuvants when you talk about the vaccines, they are the aluminium salts, and the famous examples are the aluminium hydroxide, the aluminium phosphate, and the aluminium potassium sulfate. So these adjuvants, they are not required in the live vaccine because they are creating a strong immune response, but as the killed vaccines, they are relatively producing a poor immune response. So these adjuvants, they are actually making their immune response a little bit stronger. If you talk about the cold chain, and they are required for the live vaccines, but they are not required for the killed vaccine. If you compare the cost of the two, the live vaccine, they are less costly as compared to the killed vaccines. And in terms of safety, the live vaccine, they are less safer as compared to the killed vaccine, because you are dealing with the live vaccines. We will discuss about the other types of the vaccines in the next video.